Yeah, good morning one and all. So this is the last topic in this 19th lecture. So we have already seen the first part of module 2. So there were different types of routing protocols. Then in the second part of module 2, we had found there were 5 different protocols for TCP. So just now we have completed the TCP bus, ad hoc TCP and split TCP. Now the last topic, which is little away from the TCP protocol, it is called as ACTP, which is called as Application Controlled Transport Protocol. So this is the last topic in this part, and with this topic the second chapter or second module will get over. So this can be asked for 5 to 8 marks of short note, that is ACTP. So let us find what is ACTP and how does it function. So ACTP protocol actually is not exactly same as TCP protocol. So as you can find that the performance of a TCP protocol, it can be enhanced if it takes into account the nature of network environment. That is, ad hoc is a network environment, internet is a network environment. So typically for ad hoc, what kind of TCP can be used? So that consideration is taken into account by ACTP. Especially in wireless environment, it is important to consider that the properties of the physical layer and the interaction of the transport layer with the lower layers. So interaction between physical layer and transport layer is very important for proper transfer of data in TCP. So the ACTP protocol discussed here is designed specifically for ad hoc wireless network. So you can say that this is specifically designed protocol for ad hoc network, for TCP kind of data exchange. So even though interworking with TCP is very important, there exist several application scenarios such as military communication, where a very new kind of application layer protocol might be required. So this ACTP is actually taking some kind of features from the TCP protocol, but it is improving itself, or it is updating itself for the ad hoc network. So features of ad hoc and features of TCP both are combined in this ACTP protocol. So what are the specific changes in ACTP compared to TCP? We will see in the coming slides. It is said that under ACTP, that unlike the TCP solution discussed earlier, ACTP is a lightweight transport layer protocol. That means not too many rules have been designed to make it more heavy. So this algorithm is light and it can be scaled up. So it is not extension of TCP. So this is the first thing you have to remember. So ACTP is different than TCP. Okay. So ACTP assigns the responsibility of ensuring reliability to the application layer. So initially we had called, we had talked that application layer should ensure the security of data, and ACTP helps that. So ACTP is actually inbuilding the security part through application layer in ad hoc network. It is more like UDP or user diagram protocol with feedback of delivery and state maintenance. So feedback is a very important part in ad hoc network, because whatever data is being sent, feedback should come back for that. Okay. So in this case, ACTP feedback is a very important factor, and we can decide that which data is very important. So for that, feedback must come as soon as possible. And some data which is of lower importance means that it can be sent a little bit late. Okay, so for that we can design the transmission time, or we can design how much delay, maximum delay can be expected or can be experienced for every data packet. So in ACTP, for every data packet we can design that how much can be the maximum delay. So that is not the case in case of TCP. So to say, there is more like UDP with feedback of delivery and state maintenance. ACTP stands between the TCP and UDP. So this we will see in the next slide. So between the TCP and UDP, the ACTP actually is existing. So in the next slide, we can see that the ACTP layer is existing between the application layer and network layer. So we can see that ACTP stands in between TCP and UDP. And there are two very important features mentioned here, that TCP experiences low performance with high reliability. So this you have to remember. So TCP is mainly used where high reliability is required, but its output is low, whereas UDP gives very high performance but with huge loss. That means reliability in this case is less. So TCP and UDP both are kind of having opposite features. So TCP is used where reliability is very high but output is low, UDP is actually giving very high output but with low reliability in ad hoc wireless network. So both these features we have combined together and designed kind of ACTP. ACTP, the key philosophy is to leave the provisioning of reliability in the application layer. So as explained previously, that application layer is held responsible for providing reliability. Reliability means reliability of data maintenance. That means whatever data is sent from the sender node must reach to the receiver node. So this is the most important line in the whole slide. So it says that the ACTP provides a simple feedback information about the delivery status of the packets to the application layer. So application layer is actually controlling the data transfer part. So for whichever packet the application layer is asking to transfer, for every packet, if acknowledgement is required, then that application layer is receiving that acknowledgement from the lower layer. So this actually provides a simple feedback information about the delivery status of packets to the application layer. So this, you can see this IES acknowledged message number. So this is actually the feedback of acknowledgement that is coming back to the application layer. So for every data packet that is transferred, this ACTP protocol will be generating a feedback kind of signal. So ACTP supports the priority of packets to be delivered. That means if you are mentioning here IS at 0, that means that packet is having highest priority. So in the next slide, we will see what is this message number indicates. So if I say IS at 3, that means 3 unit delay, that means 3 second delay can be possible for that message. That means if message counter is 0, that means that packet is having highest priority. So immediately that packet has to be transferred. Likewise, and if this is having 3, that means it can experience a delay of 3 unit of time. Likewise, so just by setting this message number here, just by setting this message number in application layer, we can decide whether our data packet is immediately to be transferred or it can be transferred after certain amount of delay. So this is a specific feature of ACTP. So it is saying ACTP supports the priority of packets. So immediately to be transferred or transferred with 3 seconds delay, 5 seconds delay, that we can control. But it's responsibility of the lower layers to actually provide the differentiated service based on the priority. So here, illustration of interface functions using ACTP is shown here. So you can see here that ACTP layer is in between the application layer and the network layer. So what application layer sends is, it sends a delay, it sends a message, and in that message encoded is delay. So how much maximum delay can be withstood, or how much maximum delay is possible in case of that packet, data packet, its message number and the priority. So that whole message packet is transferred to the network layer through ACTP layer. And ACTP is having two signals. One is going down, that is the IP output, and another is signal is going back. So when IP output is sending the packet to the network layer, data reaches the receiver. After that, this acknowledgement signal comes back to the application layer. And this is the main feature, IES acknowledged message number. This is the main feature of ACTP. Let us see what are the features of ACTP. It is saying the ACTP layer and the API functions used by application layer to interact with the ACTP layer is shown here. So each API function call to send a packet, that is send to. So this send to signal is going from the application layer to the network layer. This is actually the data with lot of features embedded in it. It contains additional info required for ACTP such that, okay, so this message send to, this is carrying the special messages. What are they? Maximum delay packet can tolerate. So that is delay. Maximum delay, that means if it says 5, this delay, if it says 5, that means even after 5 seconds the data can be transmitted. So the data will be held for 5 seconds maximum. The message number of the packet, so there's a message number. Okay, so not necessary that all messages have to be transmitted sequentially. Okay, so all the messages are transmitted at random. And then at the network layer side, all the messages number are seen and they are put into a sequence. That's why this message number is very important. And third is the priority of the packet. So these three important are very important features of the data. So first, in application layer only, data is actually divided into different numbers or different sequences. So the delay, Okay, delay is the most important part. That is, every data packet, how much delay can be maximum input for that data packet. So that is mentioned here. If this delay is zero, that means immediately that data packet has to be sent. Second is the message number. I told you all the message parts are not needed to be sent sequentially. So first, after first message, you can send the 10th message, then second, then 9th, then 3rd, then 15th. All this message are sent not in a sequence manner. And after it reaches to the network layer and all before distribution, all these messages are put into a sequence. And then last is priority. Okay, whether the message is having highest priority or lowest priority. So this is actually here. This part is actually explaining what are the ACTP sent to, what are the features of the data in application layer. Important features of ACTP. Now we are talking about this part. What are the important features of ACTP? Very important. So these features you must have to write in the paper. So the message number is assigned by the application layer, as said here, and it need not to be in sequence. So I told you that if there are 15 messages is there, 15 different messages in there, they're divided. So one message is divided into 15 parts. So not necessary 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sequentially they have to be transmitted. Not necessary. So they can be transmitted at random. So that is what said, it need not to be in sequence. And when the message is received at the network layer, there it is sequenced again. The priority level is assigned for every packet by the application. So here is the priority level, whether it is highly important or less important. It can be varied across packets in the same flow with increasing number referring to the higher priority packets. So higher is the, so priority 10 means its highest priority. Okay, so higher is the priority number, priority of the packet is importance of the packet is more. The non-zero value in the message number field implicitly conveys that, so message number non-zero, it implicitly conveys that the application layer expects a delivery status information about the packet to be sent. So if this message number is non-zero, that means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, anything apart from zero, that means for that message part, acknowledgement signal has to come back to the application layer. So this is the most important line. The non-zero value in the message number field implicitly conveys that the application layer expects a delivery status information about the packet to be sent. That means application layer, if it is saying message number 3 here, okay, so if it's saying 3, 3 and 10, so 3 delay means 3 unit delay can be maximum tolerated. Message number is 3, that means this message number is 3 means there's a third message and acknowledgement is expected for that, and 10 means it's a priority level. Okay, the delivery status is maintained at the ACTP layer. So delivery status, after network layer delivers the packet to the next physical layer and all, then the delivery status comes back and it waits at the ACTP layer and is available to the application layer for verification by another API function. So whenever it is needed to be checked whether the data is delivered or not, so another API function checks the message number and checks whether it has been delivered or not. So the acknowledgement part is checked as per requirement by another API function. So IES acknowledged message number. IES acknowledged message number means whether this message has been delivered to the required position by the application layer. So that message is actually stored in the ACTP layer. So that is the main job of ACTP. Here are some more features. The delivery status written by IES acknowledged. So this is the IES acknowledged thing. So what all things that IES acknowledged signal is talking about. Okay, so it reflects, so IES acknowledged, it reflects number one, a successful delivery of the packet. Okay, so that means whenever there is a successful delivery, then only this IES acknowledged will come back to the application layer. A possible loss of packet, no acknowledgement received and the deadline is expired. So if it said that maximum 3 unit time delay is acceptable and the message number suppose was 3 and priority was 10. Okay, so in that case, this IES acknowledged for third message is not received at ACTP layer after 3 seconds. That means that the possible loss of packet if there is no acknowledgement received and the deadline has expired. So deadline was 3 seconds because delay we had set as 3. Okay, so after 3 seconds, even if acknowledgement is just generated, that means ACTP will understand that that packet is not delivered because acknowledgement has not come back. Remaining time for the packet, no acknowledgement received by the deadline has not expired. So if after 1 second we are not receiving any acknowledgement till it will wait for another 2 seconds. So after 2 seconds also acknowledgement is not received, and still another 1 second it will wait, because we had set the delay time as 3 seconds for message number 3. So that is what incrementally the remaining time will be calculated, and reference of the incrementally decreasing remaining time will be generated at the ACTP layer till the acknowledgement signal is not coming back. Once the acknowledgement comes back, that delay counter goes to zero. So no state information exists at the ACTP layer regarding the message under consideration. So once all the packages are delivered, when all the acknowledgement signals are delivered to the upper application layer, then no other information related to the data transmission is kept at the ACTP layer. So it is not carrying any information. ACTP is not carrying any information for future, whether it is delivered. Message is delivered, then acknowledgement comes back to the application layer. Message is not delivered, after a certain time the message counter becomes zero. So this is this ACTP layer is not carrying any data for future that is there. So no state information exists at the ACTP layer regarding the message under consideration. So ACTP is just kind of an interface layer. This is generating all the information related to message. This is conveying that and is generating a signal back. As long as this delay time is there, ACTP will carry information about the data packet. If the delay time is gone, ACTP is not carrying any information regarding to that packet. So a zero in delay field refers to the highest priority. So just check if delay is zero. Delay zero means that packet has to be transmitted immediately, and which requires immediate transfer with minimum possible delay. Any other value in the delay field refers to the delay that the message can experience. So more is the delay time, 10 is the 10 unit delay time means this message number can wait for 10 seconds or 10 milliseconds, whatever is the time frame. So lesser the value of the delay, more immediate will be the transfer of the data. On getting the information about the delivery status, the application layer can decide on retransmission of the packet with the old priority or with the updated priority. So whenever the information about the delivery status is supposed not come back, so acknowledgement has not come back for the information, the application layer can decide that again it will retransmit the information. Okay, well, after the packet's lifetime expires, the ACTP clears the packet state information and delivery status. But obviously that will happen if the suppose 10 unit delay time you have set, and after 3 or 4 or 5 seconds this ACTP is finding that application layer is finding that it has not received any kind of acknowledgement. So in that case, within that delay time, ACTP will again try to retransmit that information. So that is what is said here. The packet lifetime is calculated as 4 into RTO. So RTO is retransmit timeout, and set at the lifetime when the packet is sent at the network layer. So RTO is kind of a retransmission time window. Okay, and for every ACTP, this RTO time window is set. So within that RTO time window, the packet retransmission occurs if acknowledgement signal is not received back at the application layer. So RTO value may not be available if there are no existing reliable connections to the destination. So if there is no reliable connection, means the RTO window will not be set, because the data will not be transmitted even if the data is there at the application layer at the top. Okay, but RTO time window will not be set if there is no proper connection between the sender and the receiver. So a packet without any message number, so you check here, a packet without any message number here, that means this thing is not given any message number, no message number, I know delivery status required, handled exactly the same way UDP without maintaining any status information. So that is actually packet without message number means we are not expecting any kind of acknowledgement signal for that packet. Okay, so these are some of the another features. So if you are asked about ACTP, so these are the features, and next page, these are the features, whichever thing you can remember, you can tell. But this thing is very important, that what all things acknowledgement signal is ISACKAD. Acknowledgement signal is conveying what all messages. Okay, so that you can write categorically. What are the significance of delay? What are the significance of message number? What is the significance of priority? All those things you can explain. And below is about RTO. So RTO, that is retransmit timeout. This is a time window within which the retransmission of packet happens if acknowledgement is not received at the application layer. Finally, the advantages and limitations of ACTP layer. So ACTP, I told you that it is different than TCP. Okay, it is a specific kind of a protocol designed for ad hoc wireless network. So advantages, one of the most important advantage of ACTP is that it provides the freedom of choosing the required reliability level of the application layer. That means whether you want the data to be transmitted immediately, you can decide that by setting delay is equal to zero. Whether you want acknowledgement for that data or not, that you can set by keeping message counter as zero. So if message counter number is set as zero, here message number is set as zero, that means you don't need any kind of acknowledgement for that. So all those features, all those very important things is giving us freedom of choosing the required reliability. So message number is set zero means we don't want any acknowledgement. Okay, so in that case the network will be light, because to generate acknowledgement signal and bring it back, okay, a feedback mechanism has to be established within the network, and that will actually add to the control overhead. So we don't want to make the network very heavy with the control overhead. In that case, you always keep the message counter as zero. So that is what it is saying, that ACTP provides a freedom of choosing the required reliability level to the application layer. Since ACTP is a lightweight transport layer protocol, it is scalable for large networks. So this ACTP, it can work for small networks as well as to very large networks, because it is a very lightweight protocol. That means not too many rules and regulations are there for ACTP. And throughput is not affected by path breaks as much as TCP. So if there is, due to mobility of the network, if there is a path break, the output will not be affected much, because there is no congestion control window here. Okay, here the window is only about RTO. Okay, that is the retransmit timeout. So after retransmit timeout, again the data will be retransmitted. Hence, there is no congestion control algorithm. Actually, this is a negative thing, but as there is no congestion control algorithm, this algorithm is lighter, and if there is not significant any path break, output of the protocol will be quite high. Okay. Limitations, it is not compatible with TCP. There is a very big disadvantage, that is wherever TCP is applicable directly, you cannot apply ACTP. Okay, so ACTP is a specific kind of thing which is applicable only for ad hoc wireless network. And use of ACTP in a very large ad hoc wireless network can lead to heavy congestion, because directly there is no congestion control algorithm which is kept in case of ACTP. So please prepare this question for 5 to 8 marks. There is only one diagram of this. It is ACTP layer in between application layer and network layer. So this finishes all topic in module number 2. So the chapter is declared, and this lecture is over. We will start with quality of service from next lecture. Thank you.